Hello, this is Dr. Lewerenz at Longevity Health Institute. Hope this finds you well and, as I always say, educates you and informs you and potentially makes you better. So what do divorce, MTHFR, and adrenal or cortisol all have in common? They all kind of stink. So I thought I'd talk to you about, divorce and stress and stress effects that also then lead to adrenal issues. And why? Because I actually did a lot of talk today with patients today, almost hoarse in their breath about all the talking related to stress and divorce and my thoughts about that, but also how it ties into adrenal effects, but also how it ties into MTHFR. So what is MTHFR? Well, MTHFR, which by the way, this is a little bit of a shout out to a friend of mine in California. We had this discussion last week, and also to a couple of my patients that are really working through tough times with a divorce setting and challenges with their spouses and just the children and co-parenting, and that's very real and very emotional and very gut-wrenching. And so even if it tends to be on the downside, meaning, a few years after a divorce or whatever, it can still really impact somebody's health physically and mentally. Okay, so let's go back to what is MTHFR. MTHFR stands for methotetrahydrofolate reductase. It's an enzyme that we all have that helps us do some conversions in our litter, in our liver, that helps us break down homocysteine. And as you break down homocysteine and essentially make more cysteine, you actually do some more conversion to glutathione. And glutathione is one of the biggest antioxidants in your body that your body can make that does a lot of repair and prevention of things. So many benefits of glutathione. But going back to MTHFR, let's talk about how real it is. Well, it's a real big deal if it expresses itself, okay? And it is very, very common. Now, people can have a couple SNPs in their methylation pathways of MTHFR, and they don't take folic acid or B12 and actually use it appropriately to cause a methylation, which is a detoxification of homocysteine. And so they have this bad gene that causes it to express itself. And so then your homocysteine level climbs, okay? And thus then you can't make as much glutathione, this antioxidant, wonderful repair antioxidant, okay, in your body. So very, very key. Now also, there's over 70% of the population in the US have at least one SNP, one allele of MTHFR mutation. It's less than 15% have four that really express itself, okay? But the key thing is here is how do you know? The first thing you can do is ask your doctor just to check homocysteine. Any homocysteine above 15 is horrible, horrible. We go for single digits. The lower, the better, okay? You want a lower homocysteine level, okay? And how do you get that really quickly? Just for time here purposes, you make sure you're taking plenty of methyl B12 and methyl folate because you're bypassing the MTHFR, that reductase enzyme, okay? So, good supplements, we use one here from Designs for Health called Homocysteine Supreme, and that actually has methyl folate, methyl B12. It has trimethylglycine and serine, and all these things are helping detoxify and bring down homocysteine and build up your glutathione pools. Okay, and they work wonderfully, okay? And you just track your homocysteine level. But why is this key? Well, a couple of my patients today did have SNPs in this, and it is a risk for things like, Hashimoto's or other autoimmune conditions, okay? The other effect is too, is that when you're a poor methylator or conjugator, okay, you can struggle with things neurologically or things cardiovascular or even energy in that. So now let's get back to divorce. So, divorce, this is a long, big topic, but whether you're a man or a woman or young or old or whatever, it's horrible. because it's a very stressful event. There's often kids involved and financial stuff, and you know, there's stress effects that affect sleep and your immune system and that. But one of the biggest things a lot of people don't grasp and understand, and I had this discussion with a patient just a few minutes ago, is that just because it was, you know, 4 or 5 years ago, does not mean it's not affecting you. And they go, well, why didn't it affect me as much, you know, when I was in the heat of it, when I had the lawyers going, when there was a lot of child custody stuff, you know, when I was dealing with a narcissist, or when there was some abuse or what have you, okay? Well, the reason is because it's the fight or flight. Your adrenal gland, you know, when your endorphins are kicking out, you're on survival mode for your kids, for your own well-being, you know, for, you know, basically survival. And so in this, you're pumping out cortisol and you're pumping out all these things, and it's literally, you feel like it's normal, you're wired, you're tired, you're not sleeping. Unfortunately, a lot of people overdrink then and overeat, but you get through that. What happens later though in divorce is that there's now, because of a lot of the emotional stuff, which is very real, and women I actually really have an appreciation for in this sense, because regardless of what's going on in a situation like that, if there's children involved, women and men are very different. You know, that old saying, men are from Venus and women are from Mars. I think I got that backwards, but you get the point, is we're very different. We're very opposite and very different, okay? We're hunter-gatherers, you know, we're protectors, we're providers. And women are much more so, and obviously there's mixtures of this and that, there's variations in the spectrum, but the point is that they are nurturers, they are caregivers, they're lovers. Doesn't mean men don't love their children, etc., and can care for them. The point being is, it's very gut-wrenching and emotional, and it actually can really cause a lot of anxiety and worry in a mother with children in a divorce, and it can really, really have some negative consequences on their overall health, and mostly, I believe, due to adrenal effects, because it affects their brain and thought process and hypothalamus, which signals their adrenal gland, and then their ovaries, and also the thyroid and pancreas. And so there's this whole hormonal cascade due to one thing, like a stress, a major stress event, one of the top five in anyone's life, it being a divorce. So point being here is that just because the fight or flight's over does not mean that you're not potentially suffering the consequences of, and those ramifications of, a divorce. And so a lot of people will really have misunderstanding why they're struggling with weight, why they don't sleep, why they have some anxiety, you know, why they're really fatigued, especially have an afternoon crash like my patient today. And, you know, we don't go through adrenal stress and this fight or flight in a month. It takes typically years, and then there's this crash effect. So we can be talking, you know, years of an effect that takes sometimes a good at least 9 months or a year to fix, okay, with giving a patient some emotional support, some psychological counseling support, some nutritional guidance, some nutrient counseling, and feeding their body and their adrenal gland, and using things like nutritional IVs to support their adrenal gland, besides all the other things that we do with hormonal balancing based on age appropriately, okay? But something that is so stressful like this, what you have to do is really appreciate the whole body, the whole system, okay? Even the emotional system, and even that emotional, mental, nurturing system. But the key here is this. Like one of my patients say, they want to lose weight. They want to lose weight yesterday, okay? It ain't going to happen. You got to get healthy first. You got to get your gut good. You got to get your hormones balanced. You got to get your adrenals working better. You got to sleep better. You got to rest better, okay? You got to be psychologically and emotionally good. You got to feel comfortable in the situation that you are with you and your children in a divorce setting, etc. And then when these things happen, okay, now you can restore your adrenal function. Now your metabolic rate can change. And now there's many benefits that can happen, not just optimal health and wellness and well-being, but now you can burn calories. Now your metabolic rate's higher, okay? Your body knows no difference what you did to it with stress, okay? Your body knows no difference whether you went through a divorce, you're training too hard, you work too much, you don't sleep good, you overdrink, you overtrain, you just got over COVID and you're sick, blah, blah, blah. These are all stressors, okay? Your body doesn't care. Physiologically, it reacts. And when you have an adrenal stress, in an adrenal dysfunction or a dysrhythmia, it's going to hold you metabolically. It's going to hold calories. Okay, so, you know, key things, and to keep this complete in this big topic, something so real and very big like a divorce that's so common, nearly half of the U.S. population go through a divorce in their life, which is crazy and very sad. And that's actually going up, yeah, the rates, and is that you can literally have all these physical, physiologic consequences. This one patient here I'm looking at and, you know, reflecting on right now here that I just talked to is that, I mean, she's really suffering from low progesterone, MTHFR, so she's not methylating. She got Hashimoto's, a thyroiditis condition with low thyroid. She's gained weight and she's hypoadrenal, meaning she's gone through a lot of adrenal stress and she's on, you know, a underproduction of cortisol, and we're kind of restoring and building her up. And she's doing better. She's about 30-40% better. It's taken us 5 months to get there. She's got a little bit of more, 4 or 5 months probably to go. But the point being is it's been 5 years of a divorce and stress that has caused these consequences. One of her major goals is weight loss. And I had to say, listen, pump the brakes. We'll get you there. We will get your weight off. But you got to be healthy first and be optimal and be well and feel that, okay, and have sustainable energy to then get to a better metabolic place to burn calories. So that's what divorce, MTHFR, and hypoadrenalism or adrenal stress have in common. So share this with others. I hope this gives you some good insight into your overall health and, unfortunately, pathways that are affected by stressors in your life. But appreciate them. Get them evaluated by your doctor or a doctor that really cares and is vested for you and your family and for the right intention. Here at Longevity Health Institute, we're always bringing you the best in functional personalized medicine. Me and my practitioners are always accepting new patients. Why? Because we love what we do. We love helping people. So be well. Hope this enlightens you and educates you. Have a good night.